Let's learn what a GPU is and how it's different from a CPU, and why GPUs that were once the focus of gaming are now the focus of artificial intelligence. Welcome back to Glitch, your easy insights into data, bots, and artificial intelligence. We've got something called the graphics card or video card. It refers to one of these. Inside of a graphics card is what helps you compute everything. That's what the GPU is, the graphical processing unit, which is a silicone-based microprocessor. For those of you who aren't gamers, you also have a silicone-based microprocessor, but yours is called a CPU, a central processing unit. Now, GPUs and CPUs differ in a few ways. CPUs are like trucks. CPUs are on most of our computers because it can handle multiple tasks, things like spreadsheets, writing, drawing, listening to music, etc. GPUs are like race cars. They're only on computers that need to be specialized for one task. Just like a race car, it's fast, but it can only really carry a few different items, so they're less good with general purpose computing needs.
Okay, I know I just compared a GPU to a race car. It doesn't mean a GPU is better than a CPU. You need to think of them as two different designed microprocessors that have two different goals.
CPU run different types of computations serially. GPUs run similar types of computations in parallel. This focused race car specialization of the GPU is why they're so important for running games. Every visualization on a game needs to be computed mathematically. Every blade of grass, the lighting, the movement of the wind, that's a lot of computations for every second you move. But because it is so fast at computations, something started happening. GPUs have become popular for other computations that have nothing to do with graphics. One of them is Bitcoin mining, and the other one is actually artificial intelligence, training machines. Remember we talked about how GPUs are better at handling parallel computations? Well, that's what AI-like machine learning needs. It needs to be able to process multiple data points to be trained. Deep neural networks, for example, can have millions of parameters to train on, all of which can be done faster by utilizing GPUs. Okay, here are three very quick things I want you to remember about GPUs. The first thing, GPUs are the physical foundations of artificial intelligence, which is crazy. Not absolutely necessary for machine learning. The only problem is if you don't have a GPU, training your machine learning models and training AI can take weeks without one. Second thing to remember is that if you don't have a physical GPU in your computer and you want to do these AI computations, you still can. Companies like Google offer GPUs on the cloud. And three, there's been CUDA, C-U-D-A, that has helped with programming the actual GPU. Because of this introduction, there's been an explosion of usage of GPUs for artificial intelligence. So you thought GPUs were just for gamers, they're also for data scientists and anyone interested in building artificially intelligent machines. Comment down below and tell me if your computer has a GPU or a CPU. Hint, if you have a regular laptop computer, you probably have a CPU. If you're huge into gaming, then you probably know if you have a GPU or not. Thanks so much. I'll see you in the next video.